When you do exercise, especially when you do exercise that lasts more than 20-25 minutes, then your brain will start to relax. You start to think maybe deeper thoughts, or maybe you don't think at all, which is also good. Today, when I was swimming, I'm just done my morning swim. Today, when I was swimming, I started thinking about stupid people, how to deal with them. And that's the topic of today. I'm Frederick. This channel is built on more than 25 years of developing people and businesses successfully all over the world. I'm building it because I want to give my knowledge back to you in a way that's easy to understand and easy to use. Stick with me and make sure you, if you haven't done so already, subscribe. And now, let's talk about the stupid people, shall we? Let me start by saying, in my world, there are no stupid people. There are people from different walks of life, different experiences, different backgrounds. And I would suggest this is the first mental preparation you do if you are dealing with people that you feel right now are stupid or annoying or doesn't understand you. You must understand that people all come from different cultures, different backgrounds. Every single individual in the world have a different agenda. They have different dreams, different hopes, different targets, different problems. And when you deal with people that you feel are stupid or don't understand you, then chances are they don't understand you. Chances are that your agenda, your targets, your dreams are just so different from theirs that you just don't match. And that's my point, and that's the mindset that you need to take on when you're dealing with people that just annoys the hell out of you. So how do you do this? As I said, the first step is to acknowledge and understand that they're not stupid. They're just different from you. That doesn't change that they're difficult to work with. That doesn't change that they may really, really make your life or your job difficult. But as a point of departure, they're not stupid. They're different. You still have to deal with them though. And my first advice is avoid dealing with them as much as you can. Simply try to avoid these people, because people that doesn't match you, people that are not compatible with you, they tend to drain your energy. People draining your energy is just bad news for you all over. People that you feel drains your energy or simply don't understand where you're going, just stay away from them as much as you can. And obviously you have to deal with some of them. You have to deal with some people. And this is where you should use my island analogy. I've told this before and I'm still using it. I'm using it every day. When you're dealing with people that are from a different path than yours, try to, if you cannot avoid dealing with them, try to take a deep breath and imagine you're traveling to their world, to their island, so to speak. Imagine you'll be part of their lives, their worries, their targets, their problems. And see if there's anything on their island that makes you understand them better. Now, a good question would be, Frederick, why would I even want to understand people that I think are stupid? I don't think you necessarily need to understand them to help them or do anything, but if you start to understand people and you get an understanding of why they act the way that they do, this will make it significantly easier for you to deal with them. If you understand that that person, he or she is doing this because these are her targets, goals, then you will understand the why, and it may help you to accept, not respect, but accept their point of departure. Accept that they are different. Accept that even though you feel they may be stupid, maybe you'll see they're not stupid. They just have different targets. A good example from work. I'm sure if you work in an organization that's bigger than 3 people, that you've encountered people that you feel are trying to block you, that you feel are trying to be against you or simply don't want to cooperate with you. They can even be smiling at your face. And when you turn your back to them, well, that's when the knife hits you in the back. And of course, that's not nice, but that's just a fact of corporate culture today, unfortunately. I think maybe where I'm living at the moment in the Middle East, it's a little bit worse than what I'm used to from Europe, but it's everywhere. Now, I'm not asking you to accept people who are working against you, but I'm asking you to accept the fact. And if you accept the fact and you start to understand why would they be working against you, it's easier for you to ignore it and let it go. It's easier for you to say, well, this person is against me because he or she is worried that the position of power will be weakened by you coming and doing this and this and this, and this is why they are against you. This is why you feel they are stupid. If you understand this, it's easier for you, first of all, to anticipate the next move, but also it's easier for you to accept that this is the fact and just let it go. And then it won't affect you as much. But I have to admit, dealing with people that are far away from your values, your ideas,